I use loose tea in a tea bowl to brew my tea for myself so that I don't get any paper taste in my tea. Plus, loose tea is just easier to work with. So, I brew this black tea for myself, and I use the used tea leaves in my kombucha. So, you want most of your mixture to be black tea leaves, so I'm brewing black tea. Sometimes I brew white, sometimes red, and a lot of green too. And you want 50% of your mixture black tea, and 40% green tea, and 5% white tea, and 5% red tea. The red tea adds flavor to the kombucha, good flavor, and it also adds yeast to the scoby, more yeast. White tea adds more of a vinegary flavor. You can use no white tea if you want to. But black and green tea are the two teas that are good to use. Tea, or black tea, I take the tea ball out of the coffee maker and I go over here to my bowl and I dump it in. Alright, you got your tea leaves back here, you got your sugar and measuring cup, and the water is boiling. That's acid runoff water from my ionizer, but you can use distilled water, spring water, or just filtered water. So I'm boiling a little over a gallon right here, so I'm gonna add 2 cups of sugar because I think sugar really makes the kombucha good. So, I mean, the sugar converts to precious nutrients over the 48 hours that brews in the continuous brewer. But we'll get to that later. Alright, so I got 2 cups of sugar for about 1 1/4 gallon here. So I'm gonna pour the sugar in while it's boiling, so the boiling of the water will mix the sugar in. And I add it slowly so I don't overwhelm the boiling process. There we go. And I'll let it boil a while. Then I'll see you later. Now the water has been boiling a while and the sugar looks like it's dissolved, so I'm gonna shut the oven off, or the stovetop, and I'll let the water, you know, settle down. I'll let all the bubbles go away and stop making that boiling noise, because tea likes to be brewed at a lower temperature than boiling anyway, so for most some teas, you know, like black tea and red tea, I think it's black and red, and then green and white tea, like boiling water. Alright, that's cool enough. Now I just dump in my tea leaves, my used tea leaves from, you know, the week that I brewed tea for myself. These leaves are used. I didn't use any white tea this time. Now, first, don't use any Dawn soap or detergent, any detergent, because detergent, even the residue of it, will kill the scoby. So, here I have a micro screen filter to filter out all the leaves, and here I have the pot that I boiled. So it's been sitting for 2 days. all the leaves are getting filtered out. Pour it very carefully. The thing to do is make sure the water surface is still before you pour it. Only fill it about two-thirds of the way so that the thing is easy to pour. These leaves here, you can just wash them out. We'll take care of that later. Alright, put the lid on and take it up to the brewer now. Now you have already seen that with my glass brewer, I fill them up and right away I drink them. But with this brewer, I filled up a clean bottle. See, these bottles have been washed. And then I put them on a shelf with 30 bottles, and then I drink about one or two bottles a day, and that's how I do it. And this kombucha, once it's fermented for 30 days in the bottle, it tastes like a little like ginger ale with a little more pepper in it, so it's pretty good tasting. You have to wash the bottles though. If you don't wash the bottles between uses, then you get a vinegary taste, and you don't want that. So you put these, you know, the bottles that you just fill up at the end, so then when you drink the ones in the foreground, and you put the ones that you just fill up in the back. So you have 30-day-old or 15 or 30-day-old brews every day. Pouring the mix is like so. You just take back the muslin cloth here. Put the SCOBY in there. Take your tea. Pour it in. Now, I brewed a little too much tea. I'm gonna put this tea in the fridge. Now, don't store a jar of tea beside your brewer upstairs, you know, as you wait for other, you know, tea to get brewed, because the tea can form mold on the top. And just store it in the fridge, and when time comes around to pour it in the brewer, just you know, put it up there the night before and let it sit overnight so it warms up a bit.
A 16-watt garden flat heating blanket keeps my brew around 86 degrees. I recommend you keep the brew at this temperature to make it brew in 48 hours. Do not use a household heating blanket, for that'll get the brew over.